Hey guys, in this course we're going to model the roof structure of the Centre Pompidou in Metz from Shigeru Ban Architects. I'm a very big fan of this project as it manages to combine very simple geometric shapes with a complex organic roof in an elegant way. Besides, I love the pattern that's used for the roof structure and the choice of laminated wood, a material this architect uses frequently in a very elegant ways. You will see that this course has a nice mix of explicit modeling and parametric modeling to get the desired result. We'll start by generating the pattern for the roof structure. We could have just drawn the lines using the floor plans, but that's cheating, right? We're going to generate them by using Grasshopper, and the cool thing of doing it this way is that you'll see how this pattern gets generated from a hexagonal grid using a reciprocal logic. Also, you will see why parametric modeling tools are very powerful in generating seemingly complex patterns in a simple, comprehensible way, and most important of all, having complete control over every aspect of the pattern, its size, its spacing, and its shape. In the end, you'll be able to change patterns with the help of one slider, and you'll be amazed of the smart logic behind generating this pattern. After we've generated the pattern using Grasshopper, we'll start by modeling the roof shape using T-splines, a sub-D modeler plugin for Rhino. By using T-splines, we can quickly model a coarse mesh shape using a minimal amount of faces and vertices. First, we'll model the roof flat on the construction plane, this to not be bothered with the third dimension yet and focus on getting the topology right. After we've done that, we'll move the vertices of the mesh to the right height to get the shape more or less right. To be more accurate, we're going to use Grasshopper again, and this time we'll use a plugin for Grasshopper called Kangaroo Physics Engine. We're going to use Kangaroo to relax our mesh to a more natural shape, and it also allows us to show the power of this plugin. When we've got our final roof shape, we're going to project our pattern we've generated earlier to it. And finally, we'll use Grasshopper again to generate the wooden beams that are weaved together in a very cool and interesting way. There are a bunch of software and plugins that we have to install before starting this course. We're going to use Rhino for our explicit modeling, and we'll use Grasshopper, a parametric modeler for Rhino, to generate the pattern and to help generating the final roof structure. T-splines is used to model the shape of roof more fast and easy, and finally we'll use Kangaroo to relax the roof shape to a more natural shape. It is going to be a tough course again for advanced users in both Rhino, T-splines and Grasshopper, but it's going to be fun, especially generating the pattern in Grasshopper. I've already set up the interior of the model to not waste time walking you through modeling these shapes and spaces. We'll focus our energy purely on the roof shape and structure. I've also set up some reference curves we're going to use to model the roof more fast and efficient. This model also already has the settings and layers set up proper, so we won't have to worry about that. There are some minor plugins we have to install for Grasshopper we're going to use very briefly. One is called the Lunchbox plugin from Nathan Miller, which we're going to use to generate the initial hexagonal grid for our pattern. When we arrive to that session, I will remind you again about these extra plugins. The installation process is quite simple. It consists of downloading the file from foodforrhino.com and copying a file to your Grasshopper library directory and restarting Grasshopper. Nothing complicated. Next section, we'll start creating the roof structure pattern.